Hi friends, I'm Dr. Salim, a holder of NET and PhD in English Literature. I have 25 years of teaching experience. I'm concentrated on UGC NET English, and I have an institution also in Trivandrum. I'm now offering you a video, and this is actually a class on John Milton. And among the poems written in the early period were Laligru, Ilpen Sirusu, Lycides, Comus, and the Arcades. Both were masks. Laligru and Ilpen Sirusu were companion poems. Laligru speaks about a cheerful man, and Ilpen Sirusu speaks about a pensive man. After writing these early poems, Milton made a grand tour in 1638. He went to France and Italy and spent approximately 15 months there. And he met Galileo also. Galileo was at that time under house arrest in Italy. And the name of Galileo is mentioned in Paradise Lost. The one contemporary mentioned in Paradise Lost is Galileo. In the last occasion, UGC asked this question. And Milton refers to Galileo in Paradise Lost. And Milton returned to England in 1639, on learning the death of his friend Charles B. Udatti, and he also heard of the impending civil war. And Milton produced an elegy on the death of his close friend Charles B. Udatti, to whom he produced the Latin letters. And his elegy was also written in Latin, and it was the last Latin poem written by him. It was titled Epitaphium Damonis, Diamond's Epitaph. And Milton joined the civil war, and he served under Cromwell as Latin secretary. When Cromwell established his protectorate government, Milton worked as Latin secretary, wrote letters in Latin on behalf of the Commonwealth, and the letters were published later. In 1694 only they were published. And during the period of the Civil War, he produced a few prose tracts, and he also got married during the period. And during the Bishop's War, Milton wrote prose tracts against episcopacy, and popular among them are of Reformation touching church discipline in England and of prelaptical episcopacy. Both came out in 1641. The Bishop's War started in 1639, and Milton's prose tracts appeared in 1641, and they vigorously attacked the Anglican Church under the leadership of William Laud, the Archbishop of Canterbury, who prescribed the Book of Common Prayers. And Milton produced the prose tract under a pen name, SMECTYMNUS. SMECTYMNUS refers to the names of various Presbyterian thinkers and Presbyterian teachers. And TY in the SMECTYMNUS refer to Thomas Young, who was the Scottish Presbyterian teacher who taught Milton when he was young at his home. And the essays of prelaptical episcopacy and of Reformation touching church discipline in England were written under the pen name SMECTYMNUS. And Milton became a teacher also for some time, and he produced a prose tract of education, and that appeared in 1634. And it was written in the form of a letter addressed to Samuel Hartlieb, a scholar and an educational reformer, and he urged the reform of universities. And he outlined an ideal curriculum teaching Greek and Latin languages as a means to learn the wisdom of classical masters. And at the age of 35, Milton got married with a girl named Mary Powell, who was only 16 years. And the age difference between Milton and Mary Powell created a problem. And the girl left Milton and went to her home. And she returned only in 1645. 2 years after the marriage. And the desertion of this girl, his wife, prompted Milton to publish a few pamphlets on the legality and morality of divorce, starting with the doctrine and discipline of divorce. and he argued that divorce should be granted to mismatched couples and praised the bliss of, he also praised the bliss of wedded love and emphasized the role of conversation and companionship in marriage. Milton always emphasized the role of companionship and conversation in marriage, and the cheerful conversation of men with women should be the chief aim of marriage and not procreation. And the views of Milton on marriage and divorce so created a few problems among the Presbyterians also. Even when Milton was a Presbyterian, the Presbyterians passed through the licensing order in 1643. And it imposed the pre-publishing censorship, and Milton wrote his most celebrated tract, Areopagitica, attacking the licensing order. And it pleaded for the freedom of press, speech and expression. Areopagitica is titled after a speech written by an Athenian orator named Isocrates in 5th century. And he produced his speech, the Athenian orator Isocrates produced his speech standing on a hill named Areopagus. And Milton, imitating the term, produced the essay Areopagitica. And he says that licensing was not there in the classical Greek and Roman periods. And according to Milton, freedom of press is God's will. And he adds biblical and classical examples to strengthen his arguments. It's a very celebrated essay written by John Milton, Areopagitica. Areopagitica appeared in 1644. In the last occasion, UGC asked a question to arrange the chronology of a few works, and there was Areopagitica, and there was also a play by Shakespeare. Areopagitica, I know, comes after Shakespeare. Milton follows Shakespeare, and Areopagitica comes after Shakespeare's plays. And Areopagitica seems to be a very popular and controversial essay written by John Milton. And it contained John Milton's view on the freedom of press. And there are very popular quotations found in Areopagitica. For example, in Areopagitica, there is a line, "A good book is the precious lifeblood of a master's speech. And killing of a good book is like killing gods, and God is reason. So if a man kills a man, he can be pardoned. But if he kills a good book, it is like killing gods." And Supreme Court of USA has often quoted the tract in their verdicts. And in the New York Public Library, we come to find the line, "A good book is the precious lifeblood of a master spirit," being inscribed at the gate to the building. And Milton also produced a few prose tracts like Iconoclaustus. And during the period, there were prose pamphlets produced by Charles II. Charles II, after the execution of his father Charles I, went to France and produced a few pamphlets sitting there. And one was Icon Basilique. It was a tract praising the king as an innocent Christian martyr. And Milton was asked to produce an answer to this prose tract, and he produced his popular prose tract, Iconoclaustus, Breaking of the Icon. And in the prose tract, Milton accused the hypocrisy of Charles and compared Charles even with Richard Thede, the hunchbacked, treacherous king found in British history. And the exiled Charles II and his people again published pamphlets like Defensio Secunda. And Milton was asked to answer the prose tracts, but Milton answered the prose tract only a few years later. In 1651, he produced the Defensio Pro Populo Anglicano. It was known as First Defense. And then again, he produced a sequel, Defensio Secunda, Second Defense. And Milton became blind by the year 1654, and he was forced to dictate to his hearers. And one of his closest friend was Andrew Marville, who worked as a scribe under Milton, helping him to compose his poems. And there was an anonymous defense tract published during the time, The Cry of the King's Blood, accusing John Milton for his involvement in Charles Fest's execution. Since Milton referred to Charles Fest as a cruel, hypocritic ruler like Richard Thates, he was given an answer by Charles II and others that Milton's blindness was a trial for his wrong stand in Charles Fest's execution. And Milton spoke about his blindness in his answer, as it was a trial for his inner illumination, and it differentiates him from others, comparing himself with the blind heroes. And he wrote Samson Agonistus also. Samson was a blind hero, and Milton wanted to justify the blindness actually as an illumination of his inner mind. And then he produced his Paradise Lost in 1667. When Paradise Lost was published for the first time, there were only 10 books. And it was published in 1674, in the year of Milton's death, as a collection of 12 books. Milton revised the poem and produced it as a collection of 12 books. And actually, Milton wanted to imitate Aeneid by Virgil. Aeneid is produced in 12 books, and Milton actually wanted to imitate Aeneid. Therefore, he revised the poem into 12 books, and the first installment came out in 1667, and the second installment came out in 1674. And we must be familiar with the content of the Paradise Lost also, even though there are the 12 books, because questions can be asked from any area. So in the various universities, the books of Milton are different. In Delhi University, they teach all the books except book number 5, 6 and 7. And in Kerala University, they teach the book 1 of John Milton, Paradise Lost, book 1. And for the annual students, book 9 is taught. And book 9 seems to be the nexus of all the 12 books. Thank you.